you know, I don't think art should be efficient. And the choice for this project was not to default to where your comfort zone is. So we're here at the Church Studios in Crouch End in London recording Quartets 3, which is the third of my quartet series. It's really exciting being here in this room. It's quite a dense sound. It's a very natural sounding space. I really wanted to bring the music closer to the listener and bring the listener into this world. It's not like you're hearing the music in a big room, imagining it's in a big room. It's, this is music, how it sounds. This is real. I want this to feel very organic and kind of communicative and, you know, like it's four people coming together as one quartet.
But just something, they're sort of all intertwined. But nothing structurally important.
So the musicians that I've chosen for this recording, they're four musicians I know personally, but I've worked with many, many times over the years. What I get excited about is not taking any of them for granted. I think the joy of a slightly protracted recording process is you want your colleagues to bring their opinions to the table. So I've got an opinion, but so do the quartet, and you know that's what they're here to share.
But that sound is perfect, the speed is perfect. Let's have a quick tune and just go straight again.
We've all got to this point where actually you could get it done in like 3 hours and go home. But, you know, I don't think art should be efficient. Like, I know we could get this done. Bang. You'd miss out on the potential for something to really surprise you. Or you'd miss out on the moment where it's not what you wrote, but it's sort of magically better. You know, and you choose players who bring the potential for that to happen. So it's not my first record in Atmos, but we're doing it in a slightly different way. We're using a sort of binaural head with supplementary microphones to capture the kind of reflection of the room. The microphones are chosen to pick up the real sound under the ear of string instruments. So we're recording to tape, which is really exciting. I've never done it before because it's slow. So to be able to have that time to really get those little glitches and the little kind of textures that it brings out. Also using a quartet of AMS RMX16 reverbs, which I'm delighted about. It's the sound of the 80s. But I think they sound fabulous, and you get this real kind of human vocal quality. Coming here where the mixing desk is in the live room, you've got to be so present and can't make any noise because then you've just ruined the take. And it's such a kind of natural, real way of doing it because music's about listening. You've got to listen, which I think we get into the habit often of, that'll be fine, we can fix that, we can fix that, we can fix that. And I wanted to pause on that and focus on the music. I'm really excited and really proud of the music I've written for Quartets 3 and for Quartets 4. Pulling it all together in a room like this with these fabulous musicians and engineers, you can really let the music breathe and find new avenues and new corridors through it that you wouldn't have found. And that's where it all comes together and sort of comes alive.